We're doing that song that I said we're going to do this morning. Happy day, everyone. If you are joining us, you have sprung forward and set your clocks to the right time. If you're watching this because you're still sleeping, it's okay. We're still connected. We want to encourage you to get up. Come on.
Wake up, get up, start your day. Shine the love and light that you are.
Hey, Cam. Hey, Bronx.
Throw your doubts and worries away. Shine the love and light that you are.
Renata. This is Neil Clausen, and we are so glad that you are with us today. We have an incredible morning planned for you. I'm going to ask Neil to switch over to the piano. This is a song we used to sing every morning back in the day. If you know it, give me thumbs up, give me hearts, give me some love. Let me know where you are. Come on. Yeah. Hey, Judy, good to see you.
Thanks for bringing us in. I loved that song. I loved all the songs that we begin with and all the ones that you guys do for us. So thank you so much. Good morning, everybody, and welcome to the Global Center for Spiritual Living Kelowna. You know, I really love that our community is reaching across the miles, and I couldn't be more delighted that, you know, we not only have viewers, but as you know, this is our annual membership time. We also are getting members from all across North America, so it feels very expansive and good to me, so thank you all. So it is truly a joy to get together on Sunday mornings to celebrate life, to practice some spiritual principles, and to remind ourselves, or remind me for sure, that life is a spiritual adventure. And I'm delighted that we get to do it all together. So if you might be here for the very first time, please know that everyone is welcome and welcome home. Dr. Kenn is going to be sharing his wit and wisdom with us this morning on the topic of surrender and release. And so I came across some good stuff about that this week as well. So I want to just set the stage. So Michael Beckwith says that 100% of spiritual growth is in the act of letting go. So releasing and letting go of ideas, beliefs, and attachments that no longer serve us is what creates a spaciousness and an openness within us. And that letting go is the very thing that removes obstacles and blocks that might be in our way of living our very best lives possible. It also is what makes room for a greater good. And if we want to change, typically we got to let go of something. And so if we are to move forward into our what can be, there comes a letting go of what was. And it's important to move with our internal wisdom of doing that, not only knowing what to let go, but when to let go. And we do have a wisdom within us if we turn ourselves to that to kind of key us when it is time to release. So I came across a great story on this in the book called The Art of Uncertainty, written by my friend, I'm happy to say, Dr. Dennis Merritt Jones. And the story is about a professional trapeze artist who is teaching somebody how to do the trapeze. And she kind of didn't let go at exactly the right time, and so he injured his shoulder. And he said, you know, if she had just let go 1 second sooner, everything would have been fine. But he thought, as a new student, she was probably afraid to let go. But had she been more focused, and this is the good part, on the rhythm between the two trapezes, everything would have been fine. So as he rubbed his sore shoulder, he said, timing is everything. Mm-hmm. So we are all living in that natural rhythm of life, and our opportunity is to really be present enough to catch the perfection of that innate wisdom and go with the flow and the timing of life. So Dr. Kenn, tell us more about this, about moving toward a greater good. So just a few things to make sure everybody is clued in for what's going on. Our center is offering anybody who might be needing some support with letting go or loss with a grief group. So these will be the next three Wednesdays that are left in March. It's at 7 o'clock. And of course, the Zoom information is on our website, as is the Zoom for our after this morning's fellowship time today. So Laura Green hosts just a casual conversation, a meet and greet, if you will. So that is this morning, right after our service today. As I mentioned at the top, it is our membership time, and renewal is super easy. Just go onto our website, onto membership, and the form is there. I love that it's easy, but I do not want to take away for 1 minute the value or the importance of what membership means either to you or to our center community as a whole. So please, if you have not done that yet, I would love for you to do that. And part of that is because our AGM is next Sunday. And so it's going to be at 2 o'clock, and this is our kind of State of the Union meeting. Everyone is welcome. However, only those people who have set that commitment and that intention to membership have the privilege of voting in the business affairs of our center. So we would love to see you next Sunday at 2 o'clock on Zoom. Again, the information will be on our website for that. Next Sunday is our pre-service meditation. This week is our coffee and connection. And our practitioner of the week is the beautiful licensed practitioner, Amanda Pope. So if you've got something going on, don't hesitate to send her an email. So that is it from me this morning. Thanks again for being here, and I'll turn this back over to Barb to move us into our time of spiritual practices within this very room.
Thank you, Dr. Deborah. What was the name of that book that you just said? The Art of Uncertainty. There you have it. Thank you so much, Dr. Deborah. Join me. Just take a breath as we transition into this sacred space. In this very room, there's quite enough love for all the world. And in this very room, there's quite enough joy for all the world. And there's quite enough peace and quite enough power to walk through our every fear. For spirit, one spirit is in this very
good morning. Take a breath with me and find that place inside of you that knows nothing of lack. It knows only of abundance and joy, love and beauty. Find that place inside of you where your connection to the divine is always recognized. And from that place, know this with me. There is only one power, one life, one infinite energy of love. I am a small but very significant piece of this mosaic that I call spirit. I speak my word this morning for the service and for everyone touched by it. Knowing that Dr. Kenn's talk is rich and fulfilling, the message is propelling me forward, expanding my consciousness, and it's coming through loud and clear with no interference or distortion. My soul is on a divine journey, and everything required for me to live the best life possible, to reach my full potential and become the person I was destined to be, already exists within me. I release anything standing in my way. It just dissolves and dissipates right here and right now, returning to the nothingness from which it came. I am open to possibilities. There is a knower that knows, and it knows that it knows. This infinite intelligence is the universal mind. It is God's mind. It is my mind. It is your mind. I know my value is not measured by how much money I have, the house I live in, or the car I drive. The very fact that I exist, that I was put on this planet, is all the evidence I need to know there is a higher purpose for me. And more of that purpose is being revealed with every breath that I take. You are a part of me and I am a part of you. Together, we are being called to a higher state of consciousness and action. Knowing this to be the capital T truth of who I am, I release all doubt and confusion. I allow myself to accept all the blessings that are constantly downloading into my existence. I give great thanks for all the possibilities. I let go, I let the divine work through me, and I ground this by saying, and so it is.
Woo-hoo! This is how we clap here. Derek, light it up, baby. Come on, that's putting a little love in my heart. How about you, friends? Come on.
Think of your fellow man, lend him a helping hand, put a little love in your heart. You see it's getting late, oh please don't hesitate, put a little love in your heart, and the world will be a better place, and the world will be a better place for you. Yeah, just wait and see. Another day goes by, and still those children cry. Put a little love in your heart. If you want the world to know, we won't let hatred grow. Put a little love in your heart, and the world will be a better place. A better place for you and me. Yeah, just wait and see. Wait and see. Oh. Take a good look around, and if you're looking down, put a little love in your heart. I hope when you decide, you pointed out,
for you
and me,
and me.
Yeah, just wait.
And as you're giving that love, share it with Dr. Kenn Gordon in the house.
Oh, I love your excitement. It's infectious.
Yay.
It's infectious. Well, welcome, everybody. Today I'm going to talk about being open to possibilities, which is the theme for this month. And what I really want to touch on is the reality that everything, as Dr. Holmes said, is paid for in spiritual coins. So you'll see behind Barbara on the chalkboard, that's exactly what's written. That nothing comes for free. Something has to be given every time we get something. I'll start off by giving you a story. It's not really a story, it's actually a testimonial example. I can remember years and years and years ago, a woman coming to me who wanted to sell her home. And she wanted to get rid of it. She wanted to downsize. She'd become a widow. Her husband had passed on. And she had this beautiful, beautiful home. The market was hot. It was at the very, very height of it. Homes were selling for more than was being asked for. And so she came and she said, you know, please give me a treatment to be able to sell my home. And I joyfully did exactly that. And she went about her business. And a week went by, 2 weeks went by, and the house didn't sell. And it wasn't that it was poorly priced or overpriced, it was just, it didn't sell. There was very, very few people coming to visit. There was no interest in it at all, despite the fact it was a beautiful home in a beautiful location. It was very well kept up. And so she came to me and she said, I need something more. I need to know something more to be able to offload my house because I really want to move. And so we got talking about it, and I suggested that maybe perhaps she didn't really want to sell the house. And she was just so upset that I would think such a thing. She said, no, I want to get rid of this home. And I said, okay. And so we talked about it a little bit. And you know, we began to talk about some of the memories that were in the house. We talked about how her children had been raised in that house, how she had lived there for decades with her beautiful husband, how there had been such a heartfelt connection with it. And so the conversation went on, and she said, no, I don't think that that's any of the issue. And she went away, and the house still didn't sell. After about a week, though, she came back, and she said, you know, I've been thinking about it. I think that there is something within me that just doesn't want to let go of all that. And so she said, how can you help me with that? And I said, well, you know, what we have here is we have a physical form, and just because you sell the home doesn't mean that you sell the memories, that you get to keep and hold those. And so we did a treatment around the release and the surrender of that. And lo and behold, within hours, she had somebody come and make an offer on the house, and the house sold. She had given up something in order to get something. And she hadn't given up a physical form. She could have probably just as easily had two homes. It wouldn't have been that big a problem, I'm sure. But the reality was that she couldn't get rid of what she wanted to get rid of because she wasn't prepared to release and surrender the connectivity that she had with it and the connection. Along the same lines, I remember when my mother was in the hospital just before she passed on. And I can remember going and visiting with her. And she was a practitioner, as many of you know, and many of you knew her, and a beautiful soul. And I can remember she was in so much pain and discomfort. And sitting across from her, talking with her, and she asked me to give her a treatment. And I said, well, what would you like a treatment for, Mom? And knowing full well that she was supposed to say what it is that she wanted, she said, you know, I'm just tired. I'm tired, I'm in pain, I'm hurting, and I just don't want to go through that anymore. I've had enough. And I said to her, you do know what you're saying, don't you? You do realize that the outcome of this might be something different than maybe perhaps we should be talking about. And it's funny that even now I can't even talk about it. But she said, yes, I do know that. And so I gave her a treatment, and literally that evening she passed on and made her transition. She had to give up her desire to hold on to something in order to move to something else. She had to pay in spiritual coin. She was very, very fond of saying, you can't have your cake and eat it too. And that housewife's wisdom was passed on. And it is equally as true as Dr. Holmes' statement that everything we have in life we pay with spiritual coin. Another story I have is a beautiful friend of ours that was involved with us for years and years and years, who was a director of a large government organization. And you know, there came a time, and he loved his work, he loved what he did. And one day, they just closed down his branch. They closed down everything that was going on. They gave him an absolute wonderful golden handshake or parachute and sent him on his way, so he wasn't financially stressed at all. And they released and they surrendered him. And I can remember that after a couple of months of retirement, that he came to me and he said, you know, I want to go back to work. I want to go back to work. And I said, well, then apply for jobs, and I'm sure you'll get one. Well, you know, he started applying for jobs, and he applied for all the high-level jobs of directors within the government, and he couldn't find the one that fit him right or that he felt comfortable with. I can remember that. And I can remember, pardon me, I can remember that he came and we would talk, and he would say, I'm not getting second interviews. I'm not getting anything. Nobody's hiring. Nobody wants me. Nobody wants me. And I can remember in conversation with him saying, well, you know, you have to move something in that. What jobs did you apply for? And he'd applied for all the high-level ones, and he wasn't getting into them. I said, try for a lower-level one. Apply for a lower-level one. No, I can't do that. He said, you know, I spent 30 years in this. I'm absolute at the peak of the power that I can possibly have, and I refuse to go backwards. A couple of years later, he still didn't have a job, and he fell, and he passed on. And the reason I share that story is because he wouldn't give up that idea of that title or that idea of that status or that idea of what the job looked like before in order to be able to move into something new, something fresh, something possible. another man that came into our lives many, many years ago showed up, and he lovely person, had been a high-powered executive, held good jobs all the way through, and he came in and basically wanted to work but said, I will never go back to work again. He said he was going through an acrimonious divorce. And he said, you know, if I were to do that, if I were to go out and start making money again, he said, you know, the problem with it is my ex-wife had just taken it all. So I refused to satisfy her by doing that. So he never worked. For about 10 years, he didn't work. He led an alternative lifestyle, which is fine, and moped around until his ex-wife got remarried. Then he started a business and built a flourishing business out of it, a financial business, and built and developed it and began moving forward. Pardon me again. He needed to let go of his acrimony and to forgive in order to be able to move forward, and that's not something that he was really prepared to do. Thank you.
That's marriage.
That's marriage, Barb says. It happened to me myself. I can recall that when Deb and I were moving into ministry, that we graduated, we were ready to come. We had a place to go to, which is Kelowna, which is here, to build and form a ministry, a church. And I remember that we had a farm in Southern California. Of course I remember. How could I forget? And we had this beautiful farm in Southern California that we just weren't interested in anymore. And I should say me. It was beginning to get run down a little bit because I really wasn't tending to it. I was doing too much work at the church that we were at, the Palm Desert Center. And we were working our way through. And I had, about $750,000 worth of rolling stock, worth of equipment. And we put the house on the market, and we put the farm on the market, we put it up for sale, and we began to entertain ideas, and every single deal fell through. It just wouldn't work. And finally, we cheated the cosmos in our own way, or we thought we did. It turned out that we didn't, because we knew full well what we were doing. We packed up everything, and we moved to Kelowna, and we started the center. And we left the farm in the control of my employees. And what they did with it, I must be honest, I don't even know. I don't have an idea. Basically, I couldn't face giving up the known to walk into the unknown. So I needed to push myself and force myself to be able to do that. I know that's true for Reverend Barb, too, when she moved from Grand Prairie to Kelowna, that she walked away and gave everything and up in order to be able to come here. In order to be able to have the life that you want, it's sometimes required that you give up the life that you're used to and the comfort that you're used to having that's around you. The Holmes statement, you pay for everything with spiritual coin, is so accurate and so real. You know, you can't be wealthy unless you give up your belief in poverty. You can't be healthy unless you give up your belief in illness. You can't be productive unless you give up your belief that you're not productive. Everything demands that you change and you give something up. When I plant a garden, and I'm in the process of doing it right now, when I get ready to plant it, I pull the old weeds out before I put the new plants in. I don't try to plant them on top of them or around them. I know that I have to clean my bed before I can put that in order to be able to get a good crop or a great crop. It is constantly there. It's a law that we have. And the law is really, really clear. You can't have something unless you believe in it. And unless you, the only way you're going to get something greater in your life and your experience that you have right now is to give up what you already hold. If you're unhappy, you have to give up your need to be unhappy. If you're depressed, you need to give up your depression to be joyful. If you're poor, you need to give up your belief in poverty and lack in order to move into prosperity. You know, when we talk about open to possibilities, we look at it from a different point of view or a different perspective possibly than one that could be truly accurate for us. That's why practitioners have such value, is because what a practitioner will do is they will go to the foundational beliefs that you already hold. They will suggest that you give up that and replace it with one that gives you what you want from it. It's the way that it works. It's the way that it propels and moves us forward into our ability to be able to do something, to be something, to have something new. And I know that there are people out there right now that are listening to this that want a new life, a new experience, a new way to do it. And I also know that we are so clear on what it is that we want. We put it forward and say, this is the life that I want. I want a life of joy. I want a life of freedom. I want a life of prosperity. I want a life of health and vitality and energy. And we lay it all forward. And we often are prepared to be able to share it. We're prepared to be able to picture it out and draw pictures for it. We'll be able to put storyboards together. We're trained to know what it is that we want and how we want to get there and what we want to do with it. But I have a simple idea that if you want to transform things in your life, that you can utilize and you can use to do it. Find out what you believe right now and hold to be the truth right now and surrender and let that one go. To be able to move forward, find out what it is that you're holding on to and be aware of the fact that you have to spend that, you have to give that away, you have to give that up in order to be able to get something new. You have to give up. You have to give up that which you have in order to move into something that you want, that you desire, that's there. And you know, there's an infinite number of potentials and an infinite number of possibilities and an infinite number of ways that you can do it. And you can do something like Deb and I did, which is leave the farm and come to Kelowna and pretend we never left it until 2 months afterwards and then say, oh yeah, I guess we did. I guess we surrendered that. There's ways that you can make it happen and make it so, and it doesn't always have to look the same way. You can own two homes if you want. You can do the different things that you want. You can have a job and still have a relationship that doesn't look strong or that perhaps you have some stuff around. But the reality is, sooner or later, to get what you want, you have to give up what you've got. That is what Holmes means when he says that we pay in spiritual coin for everything that we have. And to be aware of what it is that you hold and what it is that you believe and be prepared to surrender that and give that up is the first step to be able to move to the dream life that you want to put before you. Because I will tell you, that opens the possibilities. When I have an experience in my life where I want something different in my life, I'm called upon within my own soul and within my own being to give up what it is that I already have, to be prepared to surrender and let go, surrender my title, surrender my bank accounts, sometimes surrender my loves, sometimes surrender my family, sometimes surrender everything and all things in order to be able to move forward. And that demands a level of trust. And that trust is this, is that it is done unto you as you believe. And when you give up a belief system, what happens is something new comes into your experience. Pardon me. Should have taken that allergy pill, I guess. Speaking of which, isn't it beautiful, this spring weather that we're in, the springtime that we're in the midst of?
Yes.
We are called upon in our lives to make the transformation and the change that we want to see within our own self. Everybody has a dream of what it is that they want. And as I said earlier, I know that there are some people here who definitely want it and might feel stuck. They might feel like they can't move from where they're at to what it is that they want. I will share the contemplation that is required. Look at what you have and be prepared to surrender that which doesn't serve you in moving forward to where you want to go. You want a loving relationship, you have to step into it clean and clear. You want prosperity, you have to be able to give up any poverty thinking. You want health and vitality, it's a requirement that you be able to surrender that inner belief, often unconscious, that somehow or other you're broken. Everything is possible. Everything can be done. Some people have done it a lot better than I do and a lot better than other people that I know. I think of the story that is told of Sai Baba, who's given a valuable gold coin. And he puts the gold coin in his hand and he looks at it and he closes his hand and he does his treatment and his prayer work. And then he opens his hand and a butterfly flies out. In order to get to that point, it not only required that he give up the gold coin, it also was required that he give up his belief that it's impossible to be able to do it. To be able to move into that place of confidence that says, I am capable of doing this. This is something that can be done. And that if I let go and surrender what it is that is holding me in place right now and allow that universe to pick me up and draw me, it will take me to where I need to go and what I need to do. This is laid out in front of us. It's part of the teaching. It's everywhere we look. And it's possible for you to do it. So while I am one who recommends that you be really clear on knowing what it is that you want, I also have to tell you that there's two sides to that spiritual coin. You not only need to know what it is that you want, but you better be prepared to give up what it is that you have in order to be able to move to it. That is the answer, that is the key, and that is the end of this lesson. God bless you. Surrender and let the universe pick you up and take you to the life you deserve. Know you're loved and honored. Thank you.
Wow. Wow. Put your hands together. That's our Dr. Kenn. Oh my gosh. I want to ask you a question. On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being the worst, 10 being the best, how did you arrive here today? No judgment. No judgment at all. But did we raise that bar? That's the thing I want to ask you right now. Are you inspired? Are you uplifted? Is there a piece of you that you can take into the community, into your life, and share? As Derek said, there is no lack, there is only abundance. And as Dr. Kenn said, we have a level of trust. And that level of trust is now asking you to share your bounty. We're asking you to give abundantly, we're asking you to give joyously, and we're asking you to give willingly. So I have some affirmations that I'd love for you to share and say with me. I'll repeat the first and you can come in after. I know that my giving blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, and all that I give and receive. And please say this with me. I do give eternal thanks for the abundance that is mine to share. Listen, we are so happy that you have come to share your day with us. We're going to see you next week. We will express ourselves in ways that you will be receiving and we will be giving. And I want you to know we're not just the Magnificent Six here. We have a board. We have practitioners. We have Annie online that continues to put all of our tags on our Facebook for us so you can stay connected with us. We're going to say yes, yes, yes. You're welcome, you're welcome, you're welcome. When love comes knocking at my door, I say yes, I say yes. And when love comes dancing across my floor, I say yes, I say yes. When I need a little more of what I'm looking for, I know that I am blessed. When I say yes, just say yes. You gotta say yes. Thank you, Annie, Jan, Diane, Christy, Lorna. When the world comes knocking at my door, tap, 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 I'll say yes, I'll say yes. Come on, world. When the world comes dancing across my floor, what you gonna say?
Say yes.
I'm gonna say, let's dance,
I'll
baby.
Yes.
Woo! When I need a little more of what I'm looking for, I know that I am blessed. When I say yes, just say yes. You gotta say yes. Hey, let's say some freedom. Hi, Sandy. When freedom comes knocking at my door, tap, tap, tap,
I say yes.
He said yes.
I say yes.
What will you say, Renata, when freedom comes dancing across my floor? Come on, Brenda, what you gonna say?
Yes.
Come on, Penny.
I say yes.
Shout it out when I need a little more of what I'm looking for. Lorna, I know that I am blessed when I say yes. Just say yes. You gotta say yes. Come on, love, the loves are raining down. When love comes knocking at my door, tap, tap, tap. He said yes.
I say yes.
They said yes. When love comes knocking, I see you, Maureen and Bronk. What you gonna say? We say yes to love. When I need a little more of what I'm looking for, Kathy, I know that I am blessed. I said yes. Just say yes. You gotta say yes. Are you having fun and laughing with me? Come on. Just say yes. I heard you say yes. I know you said yes. Lorna's dancing. Come on. Just say. You just said. I'm going to hold you to that yes, and we'll see you next week. And you're going to sign on to all the fun functions that we get to do. And we're going to be right back here next week. Just say yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. I love you guys. Peace and blessings. Go forth and shine the love and light that you are.